How's it going, everyone? Welcome to a sort of topic episode regarding some IGCSE ICT skills you might have seen in this channel here. Today, I'm gonna use some web developer tools to create tables using HTML in a simple and quick way. As you guys can see on my screen now, I will use Atom to start building some HTML content. So first things first, I must clean up my workspace area just to start with a new and fresh project. Second, we need some piece of information. Today, we're gonna use this sample paper from February and March 2020. If we scroll down to the section we need, you will see a table. A table with some dimensions, some cells. So for this exercise, we're gonna use the rows and columns method. So first things first, let's start a new file. And we're gonna start our web page document with the commentary, doctype.html. Next, this is the header part of our document. HTML, head, the title. In this case, let's put some random name, my first table. Okay, let's start closing the markup tags, title. We're gonna leave an empty line just to place markup tags to attach CSS or some other piece of style sheet. And finally, let's close the head markup tag, an empty space, and let's start with the visible part, the body, leave some space, close body, and finally close HTML. Once we have the first part done, let's save our document, file, save as, select the location you want. In my case, I have a personal folder, and let's use this name. Don't forget, every time you create an HTML document, put or type the HTML extension. Replace, of course, and there you go, everyone. We have the first part totally ready. With our HTML document already saved, let's check the expected outcome, the table. Since we're gonna use the rows and columns method, we can see that the table has 4 rows and 2 columns. Also, you guys can see the visions with the specific dimensions. So if you want to make things faster, let's start creating a grid of 4x2. So inside the body section, we're gonna start with the table markup tag. Plus, we're gonna add some attributes. Width of 1000 pixels, due to our table has 1000 pixels as the highest value. Next, we're gonna add some borders just to make the table fully visible, and we're gonna position our table right at the center. The first set of attributes are ready, and of course, don't forget, you must close the table markup tag. So let's start and let's begin. We're gonna start with a TR, table row, and the first row contains 2 columns. Columns are specified with a TD markup tag. We're gonna start with some base width of 500 pixels and a height of 200. We're gonna leave some extra space just to place the objects there, and we're gonna close the TD markup tag. Once you have this, a simple and fast way is to copy the syntax line, paste it, and we're gonna close the table row. With our first row ready, the next step is to highlight all syntax lines and paste this as many times you need. This exercise has 4 rows, ergo we pasted the syntax 4 times. In Atom, we can check the preview by clicking on preview HTML package, and there you go, everybody. Now our grid is ready. The last step is to adjust the dimensions and the size of the specific cells we have in our table. As you guys can see, cell A is a big cell, so we must combine 2 columns. In order to combine columns, we're gonna use col span and the value, in this case 2, and there you go, everybody. But now we have an extra space or an extra division we don't need. That's line 12, so you just highlight that line and automatically you merge the first section. As you guys can see, we must adjust the size, the width, 1000 pixels, and the height is ready. So let's focus on the second row, line 14, dimensions 360 by 270. And cell C, 640 by 390. However, cell C is a big cell, so we must combine rows instead of columns this time. Once we have the dimensions, we can use the row span attribute just to merge rows this time. So once you click on row span, the value will be 2. And as you guys can see on the preview, we have the big cell ready with some extra cell on the next row. So we locate that cell we don't need anymore and we can delete it. We keep checking and now we have the cell C perfectly adjusted. The last step is to adjust dimensions for cells D, E, and F, 360 by 120, and the last two cells, 360 by 270, and finally, 640 by 270. Now, our table structure is complete as requested by the example, and ready to be customized with some CSS and objects as well. So this is what I want to show you guys regarding tables, so I hope you guys enjoy it, and see you next time.